Welcome back. I have an ODE based model, dx dt equal to x into 1 minus x. I want to know the time evolution of x, but I don't have a computer for the numerical solution of this ODE and I don't want to analytically solve it. Rather, I will use a third approach, a graphical method. Draw x and t axis. Draw a grid with equal spaced grid points, just like those in a graph paper. Take a grid point and draw an arrow at that position. The slope of this arrow is equal to the derivative of x at that position. Now fill the grid with arrows with right slopes. This way, I have made the diagram for the given ODE. This diagram is called a direction field. The arrows show the direction in which x will change with time. Let's take a point at t equal to 0. Following the arrows from that position, we can track the change in x with time. Joining the arrows followed by the system, we get a curve. This curve is called the integral curve. We will get the same curve by solving the ODE for that particular initial condition. Let's have a quick question. What will be the key difference in the direction fields of autonomous and non-autonomous ODEs? I hope you remember the difference between an autonomous and non-autonomous ODE. The ODE dx dt equal to x into 1 minus x is autonomous. The right hand side of this ODE is independent of time. For a non-autonomous system, the right hand side function of the ODE depends upon time. You must have noticed that for x equal to 1, the slope of arrows on the direction field is 0. In other words, dx dt is 0 for x equal to 1. That means if x is at 1, it will not change with time. This is called a steady state. Once a system has reached a steady state, it does not change with time. Our ODE has another steady state at x equal to 0. You can identify steady states algebraically. For a given ODE, set the derivative equal to 0. Therefore, the right hand side function is also equal to 0. Solve this equation to get the steady states. For the given ODE, the solutions are x equal to 0 and 1. So the key points of this lecture are, we have learned about the direction field. A direction field allows visualization of the temporal behavior of a system. To draw a direction field, place arrows at equally spaced grid points. The slope of an arrow is equal to the derivative of the dependent variable at that position. At steady state, the dependent variable does not change with time. We can easily identify all possible steady states by equating dx dt equal to 0. Thank you for learning with me. In the next lecture, we'll further explore the concept of a steady state.